Okay, hi everybody. I'm Roy, and I'm here with the legendary Kings X. We got Doug, we got Jerry, we got Ty. Hi, guys. Say hello.
Hey. Hello.
Good morning.
So this is exciting for me. It's exciting for Inside Out and for all the fans as well that have grown up on Kings X music over the years and seen you guys live and bought all the records. And we're so happy to have you guys back with a new album. We got Three Sides of One, comes out on September 2nd. Congrats, I've heard the album, it's incredible. And we have a single out already, Let It Rain, which is out there for everybody to check out. First, I just, let's go around the room here and just, Ty, how's your last few years been for you?
I've actually kind of enjoyed being in the routine of coming out here to the studio pretty much every day. And either doing video stuff for Patreon channel or writing new music and working on records. I'm already working on the next Rat Pack record. So I just stay in a constant work mode, and this is where I do it every day. And really nothing has changed much. I just been doing the same thing.
Yeah. Jerry, how about you?
Well, I've been trying to wrap my head around the new world. Everything has changed. Every day seems like right is wrong and wrong is right and all that kind of stuff. But for the most part, I think I'm doing good. I enjoy being home. I like the fact that I could be home all the time. I like that. I'm just taking things moment by moment and living my life that way.
Yeah, right on.
That's all I can do.
Doug, how have you been?
Dude, I guess I can just, whatever Ty and Jerry said, that's my life too, pretty much. Just been here doing my thing, projects and writing music and hanging out and just doing what I've always done.
But let's transition into the good news and the good things that are happening, which is your new record.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
that's my line.
I know, Jerry. I had to steal it.
Three Sides of One comes out September 2nd. Your first album in 14 years since the XV or 15 record came out. You've got to just, outside of everything else going on, be super excited to get this music out to the fans, right? I mean, talk about just, the anticipation of leading up to the record and now it's going to be out soon.
Well, I'll say this. I will say that when we decided to make this record finally after all these years, I really didn't even want to do it then either, because I never really want to do anything. I just want to stay home all the time. And then and I knew we were going to be working with Michael Parnon. I had never worked with him. I don't even know if I'd met him before, maybe briefly. And then I had a conversation with Michael over the phone. And once I had that conversation with him, I was completely in. And from that point on, it became one of the best experiences of my life recording. And now we have, a great record, and it's going to come out. I'm happy about that.
Yeah. Ty, how about you?
I honestly believed for many years we were never really going to record again. When we finally were all like, let's give this our all and do this thing. When we finally got to there, I became really excited about it because it's something I didn't expect. I really didn't think we'd ever do that again. And we went in on this and we gave it everything we had. We did our best. We really tried to dig deep. We tried to experiment and go new places. We tried to give each other space and room to be themselves and grow in the music and do whatever. And I enjoyed every bit of it. I've told people before, I really did enjoy recording this record more than any record I can think of that I've ever been a part of, including all of our other Kings X records. And I've enjoyed some of them a lot, but I just really enjoyed this one. I felt I liked where everybody's heads were at, just everybody's contributions were exciting, and it was just fun to see it grow into what it became.
Yeah. Doug, what's your
awesome
take on it?
I never not wanted to make a record. These last 15 years, I always on my mind, let's do a record. But you know, fate has its way of taking us where we need to be if you're just open-minded. So you know, finally, for me personally, finally we get to make a record, and it was the right record to make. It was the right time to make it. We were all in the right frame of mind. To me, it was exactly what it should have been done, even though I wish it had happened 14 years ago. But in the meantime, you know, for me, that was a time of finding myself, learning, playing with other people, making other music, writing lots of stuff. Just, it's sort of like just getting away from the family and trying to find myself again, you know. So it was a good thing at the end of the day.
You know, there's been a number of bands in the last few years that have come back and made records after not making them for a long time. But I find that a lot, and including you guys among this, why I mention it, is that there's sort of a freshness about the records that are coming from these bands and as well from you guys after these years. What do you think that is attributed to? What's the biggest change that has happened over the years that you come back to a record and it just sounds like, wow, we miss these guys. There's a freshness about this record.
I think the pandemic reset a lot of people, you know, made us think and go realize why we're here, what we're doing, and who we're with. You know, we're stuck at home, locked away, and we had to deal with ourselves. You know, we didn't have all our devices to distract us, except for maybe drugs and alcohol. But I everybody that I talk to seems different, you know, and just everybody, you know, no one's just sat here going, it's another day. I mean, we've all changed. And I think it reflects in the world pretty much in a negative and positive way.
Was there a different approach to the recording, Ty, in terms of tracking, and were you guys sending files back and forth? Is that something that was different than you have done before?
No, I mean, it kind of went down in a somewhat normal manner this time, where everybody brought songs in, we listened to everybody's stuff, and whatever we all seemed to gravitate toward and be excited about, we wanted to work on. And the only difference would be, in the old days, we might spend a month in pre-production before going into the studio. But the truth is, we still do that work. We just do it in the studio now instead of pre-production. We work on the songs. And when you find a magic moment or a magic idea, you're ready to hit record right then. That would be the difference, I think. Before, we would work it out in the old days, work it out meticulously before going in. Right. And nowadays we do the working it out in the studio so that when the magic is ready, we hit record.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. So when did the work on this album start? When did you guys start writing, and what was the first step where you said, okay, let's work on this new record? Were you just writing all the time and that decision came later, or, you know, what was the starting point?
I've been writing all the time, and I think we did every now and then pop up and play something for each other through the years, or just listen to each other's solo records and stuff. And for me, I was just going, yeah, we still got it. We're still going to do this. And I think everyone was, well, for me personally, I can't speak for anybody else, but I was just honing in, you know, on what I do. I wrote about 35 songs in the year and a half, you know, between the pandemic and all that stuff. And I got more older ones. So nothing's different. I just had more time to stay at home and work on them. Oh, yeah. I remember we were in Europe and I had a couple songs I had written, and I played them for the guys. And I remember for the first time they seemed encouraged. And Jerry said he was encouraged and horrified. And that's when I knew, okay, this is going to work. Because when Jerry's horrified, that means it's going to be great. Because he'll always step up to the plate. You know, that's, I don't know. It's a, yeah. It's early in the morning and I'm not stoned yet, so I'm trying to get my brain working.
Tell me about the title of the record, Three Sides of One. You know, does that have a special meaning, and how did you settle on that as being the album title?
I can tell you that one. I think, unless somebody wants to, well, you can add to it. You know, with King's X, we always, when we make name things and stuff like that, we get into this place where we start naming things and we get crazy and we have fun and we laugh and stuff like that. This time, it seemed like we didn't have any ideas for an album name. And Alex kept asking us and no one would respond and I couldn't come up with nothing. And one day he called and said, look, how about Three Sides of Truth? And I thought about Three Sides of One. And I think from that point on, we all just kind of gravitated to that and it became the album. But Three Sides of Truth was cool, but I thought it was a bit pretentious. And Three Sides of One is King's X. Anyway, you gonna say, Ty? Go ahead.
Yeah, it was all done through email, and you're absolutely right. We couldn't come up with anything. When Alex said Three Sides of Truth, I think all of us thought, that's close, but that's just not good. Said one, and I remember I immediately said, because I just felt like that's the title. And I think Jerry reacted like that, too. It was much, much better idea.
No, I totally agree. That's exactly how it happened. Yeah.